All right, it is time now for the Morning Mix on this Tuesday. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. They are torturing us.
Yes, they are.
With this aroma. I mean, Jocelyn's had an interview and this.
You had to walk away from that.
It smells amazing.
It smells so good. I don't know why we have to wait till the end of the show to try it.
I don't either.
Whatever, but here we are. All right, let's have a little fun because the holidays are just around the corner and I've already got my Christmas shopping almost done.
What?
You guys, not even all the way done.
Almost, like not all the way, yeah.
Okay.
I'm almost there.
So I haven't even started.
Yeah, the rest comes from Santa. You know how it goes.
Oh, yeah.
But here, if you're going to look for a Christmas tree, this is something you want to listen to. It means you might have to save up a little bit because that symbol of Christmas cheer might cost you even more this year. Christmas tree farms say people can expect to pay more for their perfect tree. A survey of 55 wholesale Christmas tree growers found 71% expect to raise wholesale prices. Many growers plan to charge retailers 5 to 15% more, with some even saying their trees will be at least 20% more. Tree farms do not expect shortages because this year's harvest looks really good, but they say operating costs have gone up over the last year and they're trying to just keep up, I suppose.
Are we surprised?
Right.
I mean, everything is going in that direction. Yeah.
Were you all real tree people, like your family? Yeah. Did you all buy real trees?
We used to until recently.
Okay.
Really? We had puppies and little kids. It's just so hard. So we have a fake tree. So.
What about you?
Real most of my life. But
it's
it was
that scent.
The scent, the pine smell, but I hated cleaning it up.
The mess.
I hated it. Mom and Dad, you tortured us.
I will say, our photographer Brian Kylie always told me this. He told me this last holiday season, they go and cut their own tree too,
really?
And that's like a tradition. That's a family tradition. But like you were talking about, it's the scent. Mm-hmm. It reminds me of Christmas.
Yeah.
You know,
you
can accomplish that with the candle.
Jeez, like
that's very true.
That is true though.
I might need to get on the fake tree train after all these prices going up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a lot. It's a lot of money. All right, grocery shopping can be a little expensive and monotonous at times too, but when free samples are abound, it's never boring. Mm-mm. Trader Joe's bringing back in-store samples. We're ready for it.
I'm going.
Just at some locations, by the way. So the grocery store chain is offering single-serve treats and snacks to customers like they used to. Hot coffee, however, remains on the back burner. Grocery chains stopped offering free samples once the pandemic hit. That makes sense. Other companies, though, including Costco and Sam's Club, have already brought them back. That is how I get my kids to go grocery shopping with me. I lure them with the idea of there'll be snacks at Trader Joe's and Costco. Yes. It works.
I lure myself too.
That's why I like going to Costco.
Exactly. Costco and Sam's Club.
And then it usually gets me to buy it.
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah. Every time.
So now you've got the snacks on top of all the holiday unique things that they have right now for the fall. And then I'm looking forward to the...
Have you seen what's at Trader Joe's
now?
All the pumpkin.
Yep.
All the pumpkin available. Okay, fun. All right, this next story may not come as a surprise to natives of the Bay, especially if you commute around. According to personal finance website MoneyGeek, California ranks dead last out of all the states for best roads. They looked at federal highway data on road roughness and urban and suburban highways to determine the rankings. Now, the report found 44% of California's roads to be in very poor condition. Only 22% were in good condition. So where are the best roads, if you're wondering? You'll need to take a road trip to New Hampshire. Drivers there have the smoothest ride with only 5% of roads in poor
condition. Actually really surprised about this, though, because have you been to the Midwest and their roads out there?
That's what I was
the
thinking.
Puddles, I know.
You horrible St. Louis. In the Midwest.
Yeah.
Horrible.
And it's because of the changing weather conditions.
I'm
surprised
why
Californians
so
are so bad. What's the excuse, California?
Yeah.
We got
don't
good
have it at all. But we'll be keeping an eye on those roadways when we come back.